I want to ask you what you think is going on with these crazed conspiracy theories from right-wing media. What is this about?
Folks, if you want to know why nobody trusts the media, this is a perfect example. Really, Niall Stelter, a crazed conspiracy theory, you say? Is this why you and your cohorts have been purposely misrepresenting Trump's words? That's a conspiracy?
Now the Democrats are politicizing the coronavirus. You know that, right? Coronavirus. They're politicizing it. We will do everything in our power to keep the infection and those carrying the infection from entering our country. We have no choice. We also created a White House virus task force. It's a big thing, a virus task force. I requested $2.5 billion to ensure we have the resources we need.
Remember, little Brian Stelter said that calling out the left-wing media bias is a conspiracy theory. Is that why you're manufacturing panic despite the low numbers of people infected? Strange, because I don't remember any of these attempts to drag down the markets when H1N1 was ravaging the country under Obama. Once again, the media is attempting to make a lie true by repeating it over and over. This time, by purposely misrepresenting Trump's words during a speech over the weekend. We've seen this playbook before many times. And speaking of coronavirus, what have you done to prepare for the worst? When emergencies strike, you always see news stories of long lines of people and empty store shelves. There's no need to be a part of that chaos and the possibility of having to deal with FEMA food lines. Those that know what's coming are using today to prepare. You should make a plan too. Start by building an emergency food supply. And I trust and use My Patriot Supply. You can too. They're experts in emergency preparedness and have a guaranteed 2-day delivery. Disasters won't wait, neither should you. This week, save $70 on a 2-week emergency food kit when you go to my special website, preparewithdronetech.com. My Patriot food supply kits last up to 25 years in storage and include breakfasts, lunches, and dinners. Order a few today and receive a guaranteed 2-day delivery discreetly to your door. Take action so you're ready for what's coming and save $70. Those that know what's coming are preparing. Go to preparewithdronetech.com. preparewithdronetech.com. During a speech that was about his plans for dealing with the coronavirus, he made a comment that the Democrats and their media were perpetrating a hoax with their biased fear-mongering. The media took that quote, removed all context for the purposes of deceiving the public.
President Trump, meanwhile, held a rare Saturday news conference to give another update on coronavirus. He was pressed about his comments at a rally Friday night, where he called coronavirus a Democratic hoax against his presidency. President Trump, meanwhile, held a rare Saturday news conference to give another update on coronavirus.
It's not like this is difficult to understand. He's saying that the Democrats and their media are creating controversy for the purposes of hurting Trump before the election. How could he be having a rally to give updates on the coronavirus, but also calling the coronavirus a hoax? I'm not sure that they even realize it, but they're proving his point by spinning this most recent lie.
Pretending, I want to ask you what you think is going on with these crazed conspiracy theories from right-wing media.
Much like the Very Good People hoax, which we're all very familiar with, the media is presenting an obviously false representation of what was said using a very specifically edited clip. Trump's entire speech was about dealing with the outbreak, so clearly he wasn't calling coronavirus a hoax. You know, another thing that I've noticed is that while they claim this is so serious and all the Democrat candidates are out there bashing Trump saying that he's not taking it seriously, not a single one of these Democrats has canceled any of their rallies, despite the fact that cases of coronavirus are popping up in states where they're having these rallies. Does anybody remember the H1N1 outbreak? 12,000 Americans died, and that was under Obama's watch. I don't remember any of this from the media. And in fact, Obama didn't declare an emergency until long after thousands of Americans had died. Were they trying to discredit Obama or drive down the markets? No, absolutely not. There was none of that. They were in full support.
None of this seems to match the facts. What facts are there that Democrats are doing this?
Well,
seems like people are asking questions and they're concerned about the virus. This implies some sort of political motivation, which is kind of gross.
Left.
Name some names, sir.
Well,
because this is just, look, it just feels like gaslighting.
a column in the New York Times that's, that by a prominent liberal journalist that said we should rename it the Trump virus.
Okay, does that apply to all people?
So that the president...
Oh, f*** off, Todd. Kind of gross. Your conduct towards the vice president during this interview was gross. And don't you just love how Pence immediately comes forward with an example that Chuck Todd just blows off? What's gross is that you get on national TV every day pretending to be a trustworthy journalist when in fact you're a hack that gets millions from the Democrat Party and you never disclose that.
We're going to show some remarks from the president and then how he tried to dial him back some yesterday.
No. He didn't dial back anything. He corrected the record, which you people in the media have completely misrepresented. And I just want to point out again, this is exactly what they did with the whole Very Fine People hoax.
The president suggesting in one speech, and you can read this how you wish, the administration thinks the Democrats have been too political, that they're not giving them a chance, not listening to the information. But the president used the word, one of his favorite words, hoax.
Yeah, that's because it's obviously a hoax. It's obvious that people have been calling out this DNC media hoax all weekend because he hedges and frames it as make up your own mind. When anybody who watched the speech can hear him talking about plans to deal with the outbreak. He's obviously not calling the virus a hoax, you idiots. Yeah, the president uses the word hoax a lot because the Democrats and the media are constantly coordinating to perpetrate hoaxes. That's precisely why CNN just got sued for undisclosed millions, for making up fake stories to attack their political opposition with. That's all I have for today. Thanks for watching. Please like, share, and subscribe. If you want to support this channel, please consider subscribing to me on Patreon, Subscribestar, or just sending a donation on PayPal. Any way you decide to support this channel, I deeply appreciate it. Thanks for watching. Keep coming back.